middle class and we are all part of it, and as activists we also need to look at how we can empower ourselves. There are different ways we can do it. So I want Pranav, tell me.
By knowing the law.
Which laws do you need to know? I'm so glad Anjali brought in so many things from the IPC. Because she didn't harp and harp only on animal laws. We learned that those animal laws as of now can be used, but the penalties are so weak that you're going to have to,
pad it up.
Yes, pad it up with your understanding of the human laws. And someone asked me, I think you asked me, whether I'm also a lawyer. She asked me whether I'm also a lawyer because she thought I knew. I obviously don't know as much as her, but I know enough to get by. And that comes from reading. It's as simple as that. Read your PC Act very well. Read your dog rules very well. And by reading the rules, what I mean is, look at the depth of it. You know, look at how, what it actually means beyond the point. Can you recall at least one of the very, very, very important things that she said for us to use?
428 and 429.
Yes, that. What else? She has interpreted. As a lawyer, she has interpreted certain things to suit you. And that is also what you can do for yourself. So, know your PCI Act. Know your IPC. As much as you can. Then, the media. Okay, how many people feel that the media is, they're useless? They don't help. They blow things out of proportion. Everyone thinks that. How many of you are friends with the media?
Some.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. So start making friends. You know, it's like this. When you looked at, in my earlier chart, when you looked at all the centers of power, understand that those centers of power can be the abuser, at the same time they can also be turned into the saviors. It's how you deal with them, you know. So the media, make friends with them. Not if you come across 100 journalists, I hope there isn't anyone here, but even if he is or she is. If you come across 100 journalists, you will still find one or two of them who are there for you. But if you keep an open mind, only then are you going to find them. Oh, the journalists go away. They are either writing against talks, or they're blowing things out of proportion. They have to sell their stuff. So catch hold of those whom you can befriend. Media is a very, very important tool for you. What else? What else? That's it? Just the law and the media? Yes, so
numbers.
Yes. So you need to be able to reach out and to identify people in the system who can be of use to you, who can be of help to you. She was talking to you about the retired brigadier. These are people who have been in positions of power, who possibly are still also in positions of power, whom you can identify and use. So identify people who will be of use to you. Try and understand something about human psychology. Why? Why do you need to know human psychology? Now some may be thinking I'm wandering away and away from
the issues.
Why do you need to know human psychology?
Because you're basically dealing with humans at the end of the day.
Yeah. To work for animals, you have to work with humans. You can't ask one dog that, let's form a group of your dogs and let's go around trying to identify the maggoted dogs and the ones who are abused. And please give me a call, when one of you gets beaten and, let's form a union. You can't do that. Animals, each and every one are on their own, beyond a point. So to work for animals, you have to work with humans only, most of the time. After you rescue them, after you look after them, you're working with humans. I'm finding this, and let me add, I'm not being critical of any animal activist or animal lover. I'm one myself, and maybe I don't do even a quarter of what some of you are doing. So I am not being critical. Please do not misunderstand. But I want to be honest, and I want to share my understandings. And if it helps you, please think about it. I find that people in animal activism, and since I work with children and women, I can see the difference. It's obvious that the difference is because the person you're working with is a species that is not liked by so many and is supposed to be neglected. Either to bacche bhooke mar rahe hain, aap kutton ke peeche pade. So for such people, I say, go, you do look after the bacha log, I will look after the doggies. You know? So in such a scenario where in a country like ours, where so many things are going wrong, to say that animals matter, and within that dogs whom no one likes matter, is going to be difficult. I understand, and I therefore understand the isolation that so many animal people find themselves in. As you get more and more into animal welfare, you will find that you are getting isolated. I'll give you an example of Facebook. My own Facebook page. I have found that certain friends of mine who are not into animal welfare, and so many of my relatives who are not into animal welfare, have slowly started not responding to me on Facebook. They're still there. I would still, initially it was okay, you know, a lot of conversation, a lot of things, but now I find that they are not the ones who are conversing with me. I'm conversing with Anjali, I'm conversing with some other people, but it is not them. They're withdrawn. They're withdrawn because they don't understand your world. And because if I was the type to get hurt with this, I would say, okay, to hell with you. If you don't understand my goals, you don't understand what I'm working for, I don't need you. And that is a death knell to your work. The more isolated you get, the less help you get for your animals. In a moment of crisis, the less humans whom you can fall back on to help you. Because like I said, you're not going to go and ask the thousands of Indian dogs to come together with you to Mantralaya to fight a battle, you know. So the less humans around, the less sympathy you get, the less donations you get, the less help you get. And the more you're isolated, the more the isolation becomes. It's a very vicious cycle. So understanding human psychology and keeping in touch with the human world, no matter how much you think that animals are better than humans, please understand that you are a human and you're living in human society. And you can't afford to say that animals are better and therefore I will spend all my time with them. I'm making myself very clear. If anyone wants to dispute this, please do that and I will fight it out. Okay. So understand human beings. Why they think the way they do? Who is this abuser? Who are these people who have been abusing these children? Why are they using their power like this? There's one more power base which I forgot to add. Two in fact. One is the power of hierarchy. You know the hierarchical power that we have. Business houses or industrial houses, people who you know, you inherit the power. And the other is the power of the individual. What does that mean? Who are these people who have been abusing? Were they big groups? There were hardly two, three people who have been doing all this garbage that we saw. So
Possibly they were abused.
Great many abusers have been abused themselves. Great many of them have have been isolated in their lives. They have suffered in some way. I'm not justifying what they're doing. Please understand. They have to face the music and they have to face the law. But if we understand them, we can work better in trying to get your precious animals out of those abusive grasps, you know. You can identify a person who's showing those signs. I'll give you an example. There's a shop in my vicinity. It's a barber's shop. His uncle has come down from the north to stay with him, his chacha. That uncle is here now for the last 2 years, okay? I'm seeing him, I'm watching him, I'm keeping a watch on him. And somewhere it's linking to a few puppies who have been unnecessarily injured. I'm linking it to him. Am I being unfair? I would be unfair if I go and tell him, tune kiya hai, without the proof. But understanding human psychology, I'm giving an example. He's isolated. He smokes too much. I find that he starts drinking by 4 o'clock. His nephew doesn't like him. Women in the vicinity avoid him. They say yes, sir, yes, sir. And some people have seen him kick the dogs. There's a huge psychology here, and then he is going to be watched. And I'm going to catch him red-handed. Because one of the dogs we picked up from my area had a pencil in the anus. And I've linked it to the time that this man came and the dog hovers around the barber's shop. And since he's come and since the pencil was removed, the dog is avoiding. You don't find dogs, the vets will correct me and the experienced persons will correct me, but they do not avoid their territories unless there's something to fear. Am I right? Yeah. So then watch him. I've linked it. People are just, ye kisne kiya, kaun hai ye, badmash ye, wo. I says, calm down and let's start thinking. And, you know, look for the person who's done it. Obviously, another dog has not done it. So some human has done this. Some pervert has done it. So we need to look out for it. So this is what I mean by saying, I'm going to catch him. One day I'm going to catch him. But I can't do anything to him right now. That would be fairly illegal and also unethical. Do you need to empower yourself? Do you need the internet?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Whatever we think of Facebook, we still need it. In today's world, you can't say that I'm not interested. You have to be. Some amount of internet activity helps. Huh? What else? That, yeah. I'll talk to you about how I came into animal welfare, just 5 minutes, because it's linked to that year. In 2005, I like all of you have said, I've always liked animals. I would feed few of them. I had a vet who would come on a private basis and take care of the dogs that were sick or injured in my area. This is going on for 25 years. However, I got actively into it when in 2005 I had gone out for a holiday. I come back to my area, sannata, not a single bark or a wag anywhere. I go around asking questions. People are very scared because our corporator was a Shiv Senik. I knew he, you have heard about the Shiv Sena. And he is also quite anti-dog. I went straight to his house and asked him, what happened to the dogs, Mr. Mori? So, Uchalna, means, picked up the dogs, took them away. I said, where? So he's saying, where? Go search for it. Must be at the dog pound. The dog pound was also the killing pound earlier for our corporation. They used to electrocute dogs there. I've come to know all this after 2005, all this garbage. I go there, I see the electrocution, I said, oh God, shit. And I went in, it's nothing there. Finally, cutting a long story short, with the help of a garage owner who's a friend, who's an animal lover. And the rag picking women, they're amazing. This again, when you need to network and contact, make friends with these people on the ground. These are people on the ground, what we call. They don't move around at a ethereal level like we do. They're the ones who know what's happening. The watchmen, the panwalas, the rag picking women who really like dogs. So many other, the scavengers, the little boys running around, street children. These are the ones you can befriend to come to know what's happening. So they told me, the rag picking woman in one of the meetings said, no, they're at the dumping ground. Udhar to marte, you don't know, they're killing dogs there. I went with this chap. Then he told me, no, you go back, I'll deal with this because this is a bad place. A dirty, filthy dumping ground, garbage dumping ground. And he went, he thought he's very smart and, you know, he detective. He went there, a woman pointed to a shed. He went there and he saw the sanitation staff battering the dogs to death there. They were battering dogs with sticks and stones and killing them and then throwing them in the dump. And the dump gets burned. And who's going to go searching for dogs, no? In such a filthy, you know, you look at your dumping ground. Have any of you gone into the dumping ground? You have. Aren't they bad?
Very.
Yeah.
You
so Beautiful, no?
Yeah.
So that's there, and he screamed. And then these guys caught him and beat him, and his camera was smashed. And that was the first lesson I learned in activism, is don't rush in where angels fear to tread. Use your brains. I mean, we both of us went happily there searching for dogs without thinking that if they're really there, what is going to happen to us? Only he had the sense to tell me, you go back, and he thought he is one big Hanuman, you know, going in. And he comes out like this and watch out. After a week, the NCP workers, the NCP workers go to his garage and say, कि भैया बहुत दिन छुट्टी नहीं ली यार जा छुट्टी पे एक महीना बंद रख यू हैव नॉट टेकन अ ब्रेक फॉर अ मंथ फॉर मेनी डेज गो अवे टेक अ ब्रेक फॉर अ मंथ विच मीन्स यू कांट वर्क फॉर अ मंथ इट्स इट वॉज अ लेसन टू हिम यू नो कट ऑफ हिज सोर्स ऑफ इनकम फॉर अ मंथ ऑफ अ पुअर मैन एंड ही विल नेवर थिंक ऑफ एक्टिविज्म आफ्टर दैट एंड दैट्स जस्ट व्हाट हैपेंड ही स्टिल हेल्प्स मी वेरी वेरी कॉशियसली वेरी स्केयर्ड I came to know that this is what was happening. I used the RTI. My friend who Shailesh Gandhi says this is the first time RTI has been used for animals. I don't know. It's not confirmed. But I used the RTI in 2005 and it had just come out as act in Maharashtra and rest of the country. To my corporation, with his help, I wrote the RTI for the first time to find out what is happening. They got scared because that was also the health department's first RTI. And they tell me like this, आपके पास जो शुरुआत हुई आपके बाद में तो कितने आए यू नो यू स्टार्टेड इट ऑल ऑफ सो दैट आरटीआई सेड दैट दे हैव नॉट डन एनीथिंग दे ब्रॉट आउट अ टेंडर आईडीए केम इन टू फिल द टेंडर फ्रॉम मुंबई आई लिव इन नवी मुंबई विच इज अ सैटेलाइट सिटी आई डिडंट नो एनीवन इन आईडीए बट आई हर्ड अबाउट देम एंड आई वांटेड देम टू गेट द टेंडर अकॉर्डिंग टू द टर्म्स ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट दे हैड टू गेट इट बिकॉज एवरीथिंग वॉज एज पर द लॉ But by the time some people were smelling blood, some people in the ABC program have smelled the blood. And they're like those tigers now. Once you smell it, you go after that blood and you get what you want. So they had filed for the tenders. And the tender finally goes to a man who was literally a gutter cleaner, who became a contractor for gutter cleaners. He got the contract. Again an RTI about how did this man... He's not even registered. He has no mandate from AWBI. How did he get it? Again, a meeting, and finally, idea got it. And since then, since 2006, those tenders come out every initially 11 months. Now every 3 years, first time for 3 years, giving me huge heartache. I tell you, I hate those tenderings. But we have been getting it consistently, and that is when we started the ABC program there, which started off with my RTI.